We are here because, as the song said, we shall not be moved, even though there is a very committed enemy of the community known as Wells Fargo, Bank of America, and the rest of the banksters that have devastated our communities. We need to be informed and educated about what's happening with these illegal foreclosures and evictions. There's a need for house stability that we are fighting for. It seems to me that the world is in an uproar and the danger zone is everywhere. But the corporate lives right here. And what we're saying, we acknowledge that this is a memorial service to acknowledge all of those folks whose dreams have been buried, whose inheritance have been buried in the graveyard of never return. We are about justice for people that entered into a grave situation with these mortgages. We didn't know what a grave situation some of us were getting in. But these banks have led us to the graveyard where they've buried our children's inheritance, they've buried our retirements, they're destroying homes and communities. There's an African proverb that says it takes a village to raise a child. But when you come in and you destroy the village, you scatter the elders. And as a matter of fact, you prey on the elders and the old folks. And you put them out of their homes and they're sleeping under the freeways. Who is going to raise our children and teach them the moral principles that they need that this society can redeem itself? So we're remembering those thousands and thousands of people across the country that have been, that dreams have been killed and buried. And we're saying that to those of you, and some of you are suffering from the same violence. There's nothing more violent than being homeless. There's no more violent experience of not having somewhere to lay down, somewhere to eat, somewhere to greet your grandchildren and your children when they come home from school. So we're telling you there's no need for you to be ashamed. Take off your garments of shame and put your war clothes on. There's a battle going on. There's a movement here. God promised never to leave us alone. And we believe that justice is on the side of the oppressed today. And we're promising, even if God promised that we're going to be here, and we're not going to be moved until this thing is turned around. Yes. So I ask you to join with us now in unity for truth and justice. John, stop stumping on the poor. It's unbecoming for a zillionaire to be running around stomping on the poor like this. We're concerned that we have people's names that we presented to this organization who we know have been violated. Wells Fargo paid, what was it, $1.7 million for preying on the black and brown community and giving us subprime loans when they qualified for prime loans. That's a crime!
That's a crime!
And we know this is your shareholders meeting today. When you're out of town,
Salt Lake City.
You know you're in Salt Lake City, somebody said you can run, but you can't hide. Yes. We're in solidarity with a lot of those folks that are in Salt Lake City now. Let it be known that we will not compromise. We will not dance to tunes that we don't call. We're not scratching where we don't itch. We're not bowing down. We're not for sale. You can't lease us with an option to buy. Yes. We will be here until we get justice for the people of this city.